It was my request to the Ministry of Home Affairs that something has to be done for the alarming situation that has arisen in Jammu, which has caused a lot of public panic. And I am glad that the Ministry of Home Affairs coordinated with the Ministry of Health, and at a short notice this visit by the central team consisting of Dr. Singh and Dr. Vijay was arranged. We cannot lose sight of the fact that we have a district which has lowest recovery rate possibly in the country, or one of the lowest. That is, as Rajesh ji was pointing out, the district of Jammu. And we cannot lose sight of the fact that we have a district in the Union Territory which has amongst the highest death rate, that is the district of Baramulla. So I think we are faced with a challenge which requires a huge amount of vindication, and none amount of statistics is going to actually help us out. Two or three things which immediately come to mind are, A, as has been repeatedly flagged off by the presentation also, and then it was referred to about the oxygen. See, as far as the availability of oxygen is concerned, I don't think there a suspicion at all should have arisen that there is a lack of availability, because I was one of those who were responsible about a month or so back to arrange sufficient and to ensure that there was sufficient amount of oxygen available in all the peripheral states of the northeastern region of the island territories of Jammu and Kashmir. And we made sure repeatedly, to the extent that we received a call, a feedback from Ladakh. The Lieutenant Governor of Ladakh, Mr. Mathur, made us understand, which had actually slipped our mind, that we don't have to arrange more of oxygen for Ladakh because that's a high altitude location and they already have provision for enough. So we were so much proactive about it. But in spite of that, if there have been cases, there have been complaints that the patient was not provided the oxygen in the manner it should have been provided, or at the pace and the delivery it should have been provided, then we have to actually look deeper into it. There could be some logistic issues. Infection among hospital providers also requires a different kind of an approach, and as Health Secretary was saying, we have to follow an SOP which has been devised very scientifically, very judiciously, very diligently. Then comes to the manpower. So hospital preparedness, hospital management, and coordination among the hospital personnel. I'm not sure, I think you will have to look into it, how best is the and how optimum is the coordination between your clinical personnel, your paraclinical personnel, your paramedics, your residents, your seniors, your administrators, and your consultants. So in these stress situations, there subtle issues are also coming out. Then the issue of, because I'm not going into detail of that, but I think somebody has to point out this, unless otherwise we will not be addressing this. The problem is that when you leave the patient in home quarantine and with oximetry or without oximetry, half the time he is preoccupied with this thought and apprehension that if something happens, where will he shift? Dusra aapka issue hai, non-COVID patients. So we have to make sure if somebody suddenly gets a stroke or that golden hour of a coronary event, do we have any arrangements? Are we making the optimum use of the telemedicine provision? And why can't you have a daily telemedicine session? And why can't you give a link to the person whom you think is requires it, even if he is not coming to the or medical college hospital? Telemedicine is a very easy means. And you can in fact have daily, of course it will be a tremendous pressure for Dr. Vijay and others because they are already hard pressed. Over here also, AIMS mein bhi, wahan bhi. But some arrangement they can make. So that usse kya hoga, ek to aapka jo medical हेल्थ प्रोवाइडर है वहां पर, फिजिशियन है, हूएवर हु इज डीलिंग विद इट, अ पल्मोनरी मेडिसिन पर्सन, ही विल आल्सो हैव एन अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इंटरेक्ट एंड द पेशेंट का कॉन्फिडेंस भी बूस्ट अप हो जाएगा कि साहब दिल्ली वालों से भी बात करने का हमारा। आप देखिए दो तीन चीजें करने से आपका दो तीन दिन में ही आपका ये जो इतना बवाल खड़ा हुआ है इसके खिलाफ, मेडिकल केयर के खिलाफ, इसका ठीक। सो टेलीमेडिसिन को और ज्यादा करिए। वी कैन इवन आस्क दी अदर प्राइवेट एजेंसी, दे विल कम वॉलंटरीली एंड हेल्प। एज हेल्थ सेक्रेटरी सेड दैट द कंक्लूजन ड्रॉन वाज दैट यू आर हैविंग वन ऑफ द लोएस्ट रिकवरी रेट्स इन द स्टेट ऑफ जम्मू। तो उस ब्रीफिंग का मतलब है आपने दो तीन चीजें बतानी उनको स्पेसिफिक, कि आज हमने नए नए क्या प्रावधान लाए, आज हमने टेलीमेडिसिन इंट्रोड्यूस कर दी, आज हमने ये टाइमिंग फिक्स किए, आप हमें ये फला फला हेल्पलाइन पर फोन करें, जहां जहां जरूरत हमारे डॉक्टर यहां के समझेंगे, एक स्पेशल डिजिग्नेटेड कंट्रोल रूम होगा फॉर कोरोना हेल्प, वहां वहां हम आपको लिंक दे करके दिल्ली भी बात करा सकते हैं ऑन अ स्पेसिफाइड टाइम। आपको अगर हॉस्पिटलाइज होना हो तो कौन सा आपको हेल्पलाइन नंबर आपका चलना चाहिए पहले, ऐसे हेल्पलाइन नंबर ना हो जहां से रिस्पॉन्स ही ना आए तो उससे भी आपका आधा काम खराब हो जाता है। सो समबडी हैज टू क्रॉस चेक देम एट रैंडम, वो बहुत जरूरी है। और उसमें ये भी बताया जाए डेली कि हमारा ऑक्सीजन का ये प्रोविजन है, ये थोड़ी थोड़ी शॉर्टकमिंग हमारे नजर में आई, हमने उसको आज